Good morning, Scottsdale kids. It's Mr. Trevor here. I'm excited that you're back with us for another week of an exciting experience together. Today, we're gonna dive into our big picture question and memory verse. So let's start with our big picture question. Our question is, what makes people so special? Well, people are special because we're made in God's image as male and female to know Him. You got it. What does it mean to be made in God's image? It doesn't mean that we look exactly like God. It means that God has given us special personality traits that are just like His. So when God is happy, I can be happy. Or when God is sad, I can feel sadness. We have been given a reflection of what God is like, and that is how we are made in the image of God. Wow! Now, I'm sure that you remember our memory verse. Our memory verse comes from the book of John this month, and it's John 3:16, and it says, "For God so loved the world that He gave His one and only Son, that whoever believes in Him should not perish, but have eternal life." Now, we're doing the John 3:16 memory verse challenge. And I wanna highlight two special people in our ministry that's doing such a great job with it. And that is Liam and Cole Tucker. They have decided to draw it, and they've also decided to sing it.
John 3:16. "For God so loved the world, He gave His one and only Son, that whoever believes in Him should not perish, but have eternal life."
Well done, friends. I cannot wait to see more pictures and videos from you. So here's what I want you to do. I want you to draw it, sing it, act it out, anything fun that you can think of. And I want you to email us at shkids@scottshill.org and show us all the amazing things that you're doing with our John 3:16 challenge. Now, let's get ready to sing together as we sing about building our lives on the love of Jesus.
Holy, there is no one like You. There is none beside. Hey Scottsdale kids, it's Miss Rachel here. I have been missing you guys so much, but I'm so excited to be bringing you the Bible story today about an encounter that Jesus had with a man named Nicodemus. But before we get into that, I have a question for you guys. Have you guys ever had a question that you've been dying to ask, but you just weren't sure how people were gonna respond? Maybe they were like, oh, she should know the answer to that. Or maybe it just wasn't a good question. I have felt that way too. And today in our story, you're gonna see that Nicodemus, he felt the same way about a question that he had for Jesus. So today in our story, we're gonna be talking about a man named Nicodemus. He was a Pharisee, a leader of the Jews. So that means that he knew a lot about God's law, and he even taught people about God's law. So we're gonna go into scripture in John chapter 3:1-6, and read about the interaction that Jesus had with Nicodemus. So it says, "Now there was a man of the Pharisees named Nicodemus, a ruler of the Jews. This man came to Jesus by night and said to him, 'Rabbi, we know that you are a teacher come from God, for no one can do these signs that you do unless God is with him.' Jesus answered him, 'Truly, truly, I say to you, unless one is born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God.' Nicodemus said to him, 'How can a man be born when he is old? Can he enter a second time into his mother's womb and be born?' Jesus answered, 'Truly, truly, I say to you, unless one is born of water and the Spirit, he cannot enter the kingdom of God. That which is born of flesh is flesh, and that which is born of the Spirit is spirit.'" Now there's a couple things that I want to point out in this passage that I think are really important. The first one is that Nicodemus came to Jesus at night. Now you're probably thinking, Miss Rachel, that doesn't seem very important. Why does it matter what time of the day he came to Jesus? It's important because it shows that Nicodemus, he didn't want anybody to see him talking to Jesus. He especially didn't want the other Pharisees to see him asking Jesus questions or talking to Jesus, because the Pharisees, they didn't really like Jesus. And if they saw him talking to him, they would have kicked him out. And that is not what Nicodemus wanted. The second thing is that when in verse 3, when it says, "Unless one is born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God." What does born again mean? That doesn't seem to make much sense that you could be born again. And Nicodemus had the same reaction. He said, "How can a man be born when he is old? Can he enter a second time into his mother's womb and be born?" That's crazy. And so I'm gonna explain what being born again means. Born again means that you are given a new life. It's a spiritual birth, not a physical birth again. And so I know that can get kind of confusing. So I have a little illustration. I have these old pair of shoes that you can see, they have a hole in them. They're kind of faded. They're pretty broken. Kind of like our old life. And so if your mom came home one day and you had these shoes and your mom said, here's a new pair of shoes so you can get rid of the old ones. If you looked at her and you said, "No, I thought you were just gonna clean up these and make them look good and I was gonna keep wearing these." No, you're gonna throw those away and you're gonna take those new shoes and say, "All right, these are my new shoes that I'm gonna wear." That's what being born again is. It's when you take your old life and God throws it away and he gives you a completely new life. Just like that, you can see that when you are given a new life, you don't just do the same things that you did in your old life. You're gonna live a different life. You're gonna obey God and you're gonna wanna please God with everything you do. And the biggest thing about being born again is that when we are born again, we can have eternal life with God. Nicodemus thought that if he just followed all the laws, then he would be fine. But Jesus taught him that he couldn't do anything on his own to earn eternal life. Eternal life comes from God and being born again. And the only reason that we can have the opportunity to be born again is because God sent his only son, Jesus, to die on the cross for our sins. And you might be thinking, that sounds pretty familiar. That's because it's our memory verse for this month, John 3:16. For God so loved the world that he gave his only son, that whoever believes in him should not perish but have eternal life. We have the opportunity to have eternal life with God. We just have to choose to trust in him and be born again. Because when we are born again, we can have eternal life with God. I love you guys so much, and I'm so excited that I got to teach you this morning. And I was kind of jealous. Last week, Mr. JT got some fist bumps from you guys, so I want some air hugs because I've been missing my hugs. So right now, everybody put your arms out. We're gonna do some air hugs, air hugs, air hugs. And if you're watching this with your family, you can go ahead and give them a hug too. I love you guys and hope you have a great week.
Thanks for watching Scottsdale Kids. I hope you enjoyed our video today. Don't forget, there are other opportunities for you to engage in what we're doing. First, there are links in the description below for activity pages, and everyone has their own page. You have one if you're a preschooler, if you're a younger kid in first or second grade, if you're an older kid in third through fifth grade. Make sure to print those out and enjoy doing those. Also, we're gonna have some family discussion questions that pop up on the screen. We want you to really pay attention to those and discuss those things as a family, because we've crafted those questions just for you. Finally, remember we have our memory verse challenge for John 3:16, but we also have just the desire for you to send in any videos of you participating in our kids' content, whether it's the big picture question and answer or worshiping with the motions to the music, whatever it is, we want to see those videos of you engaging with our kids' content. You can send those videos to shkids@scottshill.org. We love you guys so much and can't wait to see you again soon. Bye.